Hello friends, today I am going to share with you a very interesting concept in leadership called as servant leadership. I personally consider this as one of the most wonderful ways in which a corporate leader, a manager or a supervisor can demonstrate leadership at the workplace. For those who are not familiar with the concept of servant leadership, let me explain. You see, most managers or supervisors at the workplace behave with their subordinates as if the subordinates are there to serve them. They ask them, guys, what can you do for me so as to achieve the organization's objectives? Servant leaders, in contrast, do something very different. They call their people and ask them, guys, what can I do for you so that you can achieve the organization's objectives in a better way? Let me give you an example in the form of an analogy. In this picture, you can see sheep along with a shepherd. Now, my question is, who is there for whom? Is the sheep there for the shepherd, or is the shepherd there for the sheep? Some people respond that sheep are there for the shepherd. Some say that both are there mutually for each other. However, I personally think that there is no doubt that the shepherd is there for the sheep. Does the shepherd give wool? No, that's what the sheep are there for. Then what exactly is the role of the shepherd? The shepherd is there for the sheep, to take care of the sheep, to ensure that the sheep is well fed, to make sure that they are nurtured, they are protected from wild animals, protected from skin infections or any diseases, with the objective that they produce good quantity and quality of wool. So the job of the shepherd is to serve the sheep. In a similar way, in a corporate environment, or the execution has to be done by the subordinates, by the team, then what exactly is the role of the manager or the leader? The leader is there for the subordinates. The job of the manager, leader or supervisor is to serve the team, serve the subordinates by providing them with the right resources, with the required training, with support, guidance, problem solving, and whatever is required in order to get the job done successfully. That is precisely what servant leadership is all about. I always tell corporate managers that normal managers and supervisors say, guys, what can you do for me? Whereas servant leaders are the ones who say, guys, what can I do for you? And by doing that, the leader is taking the ownership of the performance. The leader is not just telling the subordinates to perform, but is also highlighting his or her own role in terms of making that performance happen. And I personally think that is exactly what a manager or leader is paid for. Not to do the job himself or herself, but to get the job done and to provide the support that is required to get the job done successfully. And when your people tell you what support they need from you and you provide it to them, then don't you think as a leader, you earn tremendous amount of respect from them? And don't you think that also gives you the right to demand performance from them? So it's an added advantage. Servant leadership is absolutely amazing in the way it can help you get performance delivered from a team. But remember, first comes the giving, and then that is followed by your right to demand performance from the team. If you happen to be a parent, then don't you think at home your job is nothing else but to be a servant leader? You don't ask your children, what can you do for me? Instead, you ask them, what can I do for you so that you can be successful in life? The same principle simply has to be applied at your workplace as well. So try this. Call your team together. Ask them, what can I do for you? Listen to them carefully and see how you can serve them to make their jobs easier, more effective, and more productive. Thank you.